We are live now. Sorry about that. Good morning, everyone. Sarge, turn your TV volume off, please.
And your phone.
Try not to talk. Yeah. There you go. I'll put it out there. Oh, there you go, Facebook. Hello. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, everyone. Okay, so let me go to Facebook, 103.7 The Buzz. Huh, we're on.
Yeah, we're on. We've been on.
Who's the first one on there? Eva and Katie. Huh.
That's nice.
That's really nice. Okay, so listen, big show, the day before the eclipse where everybody's panicking. Ain't nobody panicking out there. Caroline?
They're prepared. That's why they're not prepared.
Did you see a lot of traffic out there? What did I say 2 weeks ago? We're blowing this up. We're blowing it up. We're making people panic. Go to grocery stores. Get all your food. Go to gas station. Get all your gas. Although I drove through Sam's yesterday and it was shut down.
There's empty milk stations and bread aisles. There's empty. But, I mean, the traffic on the interstate is pretty bare.
Yeah, closer. So, listen, we got a big show. I got a couple of new callers. Quincy's not new. Number 97, defensive lineman for the Arkansas Razorbacks. He is going to call in, give us a little update of what's going up on the hill. I know it ain't got nothing to do with fishing, but Quincy's a cool dude. Loves to fish. And then we have a new caller. She was a former Razorback softball player, Dana Huckabee. She watches dogs while you're fishing or camping or vacationing. So she's going to call in. Of course, we have all our pro guys that's going to call in. Bonner B's got all the fishing going on. The state of Arkansas is on fire right now. Also, Bonner, I went by his shop Thursday. And Scott Suggs was in the house. And blessed me with an interview on Channel 4. Really good. Really good.
He's a great guy.
Yeah, he is. He is. What did you exactly do to his boat back there?
We had to swap out power pole charges. We were having some issues with the one that was in his boat. And he had to get out of town pretty quick. So it was kind of one of those things where we need to get one in quick, get it put in his boat, and get him out of town.
Mm.
So, but it's all fixed up now.
Of course it is. That's why they come to you. He is number one. We got people from out of state that actually come to see Bonner, especially from the state of Texas. For some reason, this show has reached hard in the state of Texas, which I love state of Texas. Nothing wrong with it. It's our neighbor. We're about to go live in 30 seconds with some good national anthem and by our very own Susanna Watt. Maybe y'all didn't know that. She is a local celebrity. I think she's in politics now. I think she's getting into politics. I'm not real sure, Caroline Rigg. Maybe you should look at that.
Yeah. Okay.
Speaking of which, it's time to switch over.
Go.
Oh, say, can you see? By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was but still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Wherever they're biding, that's where you're gonna find them. Got the blast bowl gassed up, tackle box, coffee cup, country boy living large. Just another day in the natural state, fishing Arkansas with Big Sarge.
Good morning, Fishing Arkansas fans. It's back, baby. It's Sunday, the day before the eclipse. Look out.
It's coming.
Bring it on.
So let me just explain this to you, fellas and girls. Facebook, 32,000 viewers in 90 days.
That's awesome.
That is a record for the buzz. I'm looking for 64 now, if you don't mind. Would you please keep sharing and get that baby out there? Because here's the deal. That's how you get famous. Right, mm-hmm. Carolina Rigg?
Yeah.
I mean, you're already famous. Matter of fact, I'm fixing to make you more famous. Right now, I'm presenting you something that Rick Carter said we're going to give to Miss Carolina Rigg. Aww. Is this beautiful plaque. She caught her personal best at Lake Fork. And so it says, Fishing Arkansas Lake Fork Hog Award, spring 2024. If you're looking at Facebook, you're looking at it right there. Here you go.
Awesome.
I know.
Thank you.
I know.
I was with you on this one.
Of course you were, because I'm the best guy out there.
That was fun.
Man, I'm pumped up. Good morning, Bonner B.
Good morning.
This man has been so busy that he doesn't know what to do himself.
He's
right?
Still busy right now.
Yeah, you know, it's that time of the year that everybody's needing their stuff done. And so we, you know, we accommodate that the best we can. Yes, the shop is very busy, but if you have a little problem or something like that, we're always willing to work you in. So if you're dealing with a little issue that you can't quite figure out, don't hesitate to call us.
Well, he's like Pitbull. He's known worldwide, especially from the folks, our neighbors from Texas. They come up here with their boats all the time. I want to say good morning to Lee Gleggin Chips, or Gleghorn, whatever you want to say. Our young man is fishing the mega big bass on Lake Fork, Bonnerby.
Really?
He sure is. He left this morning at 4 a.m. He's going straight to where he caught that 8-pounder 2 weeks ago. And it's 15,000 every hour.
Oof.
Oh. Let
what?
Me tell you something. If I didn't have
every
this show,
hour,
I'd be
you
gone.
Say?
If you win that hour, it's 15 grand.
Wow.
We can't do this without sponsors. By the way, if you want to sponsor this show, bring it on. I'm ready. 8 years and we're still pumping. I've got the numbers to prove it. 115,000 listeners, 32,000 viewers. So we got the numbers to back you up.
That's awesome.
Frank Fletcher Dodge, which, by the way, you like my video?
Loved it.
Thank you very
Good
much.
Good job.
Holiday Inn Express Suites in Russellville. Fishing Stuff. Shelters Insurance.
Jamie Marsh.
She is a Angel, Cooper's Nursery, Greg Orr Marine, Stanley's Hardware, Axles Plus, Moitz RV, which, Mike, if you are listening, the good question came up about what? Renting? Mm-hmm.
Renting RVs.
Is that possible, Mike? Because she has something on her vacations that's kind of cool. What's the show about?
Yo, pick up the phone.
What's up? Brought to you by Stanley Hardware and Lumber in North Little Rock, located at 4308 MacArthur Drive. They've been in business for over 100 years, so if they've been in business that long, they know what they're doing. Check out their Facebook page or go to their website at stanleyhardwarenlr.com. You can also call them at 753-2470. I bet they can tell you.
What's that?
All right, we are going to kind of roll because we do have a lot of phone calls today. By the way, Bonner, or Drop Shots at Drill. Somebody was asking. Yes, once a month he has to do that. I did it for 34 years, so it's time for me to take a break. Fishing Ever 15 with Bonner Brown. We have a special call from number 97, Arkansas Razorback, Quincy Rhodes. Just an update. Hey, I know this is fishing, just an update. Former Razorback softball player Dana Huckabee is going to call in. She has a special announcement about us anglers when we have dogs, where to bring them.
All right.
Larry Nixon report. Camping, cooking, events, oh, you name it. Carolina Riggs got it. Bonner Brown's got what's new in the electronic world. We got our pro guys calling in. Ponies are back. They were off last week.
Well, last Sunday, yes, for Easter, but yes, they run today.
Long Shot Leo has those. And then this is kind of cool. Carolina Rig has the 9 best places. We've been covering this for a year, but tomorrow is it. So she has 9 places to go and watch the eclipse for the totality, you know, 4 minutes, 3 minutes, whatever. Let's do some shout outs.
Do you hear that? It's time for shout-outs on Fishing Arkansas.
Carolina Rig.
I'm shouting out Drew Dyer. That's my daughter's little boyfriend. He has been fishing every weekend. Mm. So back to basics. Mm-hmm. He would be a good one for that. He doesn't know anything about it, I don't think.
He needs to listen to the show.
He does. He's just getting started in it. So Emily said yesterday he's going fishing again, Mom. I'm like, good for him.
He's doing it the best time, too, because they're biting.
Yeah.
Is that all you got?
Yeah.
Bonner B.
Yeah, I'm going to give a shout-out to my lovely wife. She's always putting up with my shenanigans. And
you have some shenanigans.
Yes. The long hours is the main thing.
That is. And you know, that's rough. When you own your own company, that's the way it is.
That's just it. Somebody's got to be there. So I love you very much.
Good job. How about you, young man?
I have 2, actually. And before I do the first one, I need to do this.
Go, Sean. It's your birthday. We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip a card like it's your birthday.
Happy birthday, Mr. President.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Hurrah!
Happy birthday.
You may not necessarily be the president, but he's BMOC in these parts. Justin Akery has a birthday today.
Oh!
I will not tell you how old he is. If you follow him on his socials, I'll let him tell you how old he is. I'll just say it's a biggie.
72 is what I heard.
No, not quite 72. So I'm going to give you, I'm going to have Justin's back on that
one. Happy birthday, Justin.
Well, he ought to be listening. If he's not, then take that back.
The second one, unfortunately, is not quite as pleasant as that first one. You've heard me mention a former coworker by the name of Pete Perkins.
Yeah.
Former Democrat Gazette sports writer, former co-host with Randy Rainwater on Drive Time Sports. He had a pretty significant medical emergency about 18 months ago, had spent some time in the hospital and in rehabilitation, had recently gotten back home and was on the road to recovery, and was found expired on Friday.
Sorry to hear that.
Condolences to his family.
Hate that.
Let's see. April 13th, Devil Fork, Hooked on Band. You can get all the instructions to that on get5bass.com. My boy's on the river right now. Already caught one with a frog. Brad, Cheryl, what's up, Bob? Arkansas National Guard's drilling today, and my lodging crew, good morning. Yesterday at McSwain's, I ran into 50 people, every one of them listening to our show. Thank you again if I seen you yesterday at McSwain's. Welcome back to the 100 soldiers from the 1st Battalion, 153rd Infantry. They've been gone 11 months to deployment of Southwest Asia. And then shout out to my wife for fishing with me yesterday. She only got in a tree 12 times.
Stop it.
No, she was in it once. All right, Fishing Arkansas, I'll be right back.
I think we'll cover what Teresa mentioned. What's up with the props on the power poles?
Oh, that's a good one.
Let's see breaks.
I think it's too much, but whatever.
I think we'll cover down on that a little bit.
Come back with, we're going to do that.
Okay.
Right off the bat. I'm just going to give you a hint, and then we'll go into weather.
All right, so I'll do a generic.
Yeah.
And then you talk, give me your hint, and I'll hit that.
I'm going to say.
We need a mock.
I'm going to say bass season. Eclipse. Boom.
Yeah, that is so loud.
What?
Her headphones are like.
Katie Brown. There are a lot of shenanigans.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey, did y'all have fun four-wheeler or whatever y'all did Saturday?
We didn't get to go.
Oh!
I know it. Well, we'll make a different plan.
Did you have to work?
No, I didn't have to work, but we did, we had a few things needed to get done around the house. But long story short, the farm is a beautiful place, and it's a place we get to go pretty regularly. But the man that owns the farm had his whole family down for the weekend. Oh. So I try not to disturb and go down there whenever he's got that.
A lot of people don't know that you used to take care of their horses.
Yeah, I used to manage a thoroughbred farm for John Ed Anthony. Yeah. And the winningest owner in Oakland history.
Say.
Really?
Yep. So I managed his thoroughbred farm for 12 years.
So you know all about horses, too?
Unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be perfectly fine if I never see another one again in my entire
life. Oh, my.
Really?
Oh, my gosh.
You know what I like to watch on TikTok is them shoeing those horses. I don't know why. It's just entertaining.
You take a retired thoroughbred that's already high strung, and now they're not used to getting handled as often. And you try to hold them while they're doing that process, the farrier, and that sort of thing.
So,
it's just
Todd, since he called, let's go ahead and do my thing here.
I'm sure.
Mm-hmm. It is.
And then we'll do that, then the weather.
Okay.
Glad
to be done
that.
With it.
This has got to be the windiest I have seen the state of Arkansas. People don't really know what happened on Tuesday night. It was 43 mile an hour gust.
Sarge, just give me a don't just go right into it because I've got to switch up pages here. So, kind of give me a minute to, and then when I give you
on this, you mean
For that.
Okay,
that's a beautiful place, 3,000 acres.
Wow, where is
all right,
it?
All right, time to switch back, everyone.
Hot Springs.
Welcome back to Fishing Arkansas. Here's Big Sarge.
So our beautiful music today, Bass Assassins picked it out, especially for the eclipse being tomorrow, right? We're going to talk about this eclipse because you are very nervous about this.
It's the end of the world as we know it.
Let's go. Get it on.
Not over yet.
If you
know, Sarge, it's the eclipse, not the apocalypse. Okay, maybe not the most recognizable part of the song, but you know what this song is.
You know it, remember?
I had to play at least a little bit of it today. I think I'd be remiss if I hadn't.
I love it. All right. So,
It's not over yet.
You.
It's not even here yet.
I know. I'm just saying. You went down that road, and I just wanted to play around with you this morning, okay? Mm-hmm. But we do have, before we get to weather report, we're going to get a fish report real quick.
Every good team needs a coach. It could be a team of coworkers. It could be in the classroom. It even extends to fishing. Now, the man we're about to bring on is known as the fishing coach. When you check out his YouTube channel, you'll see he'll help you catch fish, maybe even catch your personal best, and he'll help teach you how to use the latest electronics while he does it. He's the head fishing coach at Nashville High School. He's a guide on both Lake DeGray and Lake Wachita. Here's Jimmy Easterling on Fishing Arkansas.
Well, that's perfect, Jimmy. Tell me what's going on Lake DeGray and Lake Wachita.
Oh, good morning. Good morning, guys. I was on Wachita this last week, but I did get a report from DeGray yesterday that was very positive, which, you know, DeGray lately has been hit and miss. But DeGray, the water levels are coming down. And with that, what it's kind of done in the middle to back half of creek is kind of concentrated some fish. And they're shallow, but kind of look for that first piece of cover in that middle to back half that's on your structure, such as your points, your rounded points. I had a couple guys catch them really good off rock transitions yesterday with a jig, Texas rig, and a swim bait. Wacky rig this week out there from a couple guys I know that fished it, man, didn't catch any females. It was catching more of the males, the buck bass. Now, Washita, though, man, it was a good week out there. That lake is so big, as you guys know, and the fish are in all phases of the spawn. I started catching post-spawn bass on my offshore electronic trips this week. But the west end of the lake is further along than the east end. And even on the east end, I've gone on areas where I've not even seen beds yet when I have gone up shallow trying to see them with my eyes. But same thing kind of with Washita. I like to throw a swim bait in the middle of the back half of creeks and even on your main lake points just to try to cover water. And then the Carolina rig is still, of course, going to catch a lot of fish as well. That swing head jig with the cross style, or even what I've been doing lately, putting a fluke style bait on it, is another bottom bait if you like to throw the bottom bait, fill the rock, fill your bites. And then, of course, you can never forget about that wacky rig, the trick worm, the Cinco, your natural colors or your bright colors. On my offshore trips this week, as we caught some fish, I mean, still in the middle of them drains. Like, those cool nights we had, pulled some of them fish off, and they were in the middle part of the drains, which is like your ditch in these pockets, but they were in the furthest back section where, like, it's the deepest until it gets shallow. And when you found a group of them, oh, watch out. I mean, it was fun.
Okay. Well, so, folks, if you're listening right now and you're looking for somebody to take you out and just kind of get you familiar with your live scope, which you buy over here at Bonner Brown's place, Beast Outdoor Innovation, Jimmy can take you to Lake Washita or Lake DeGray. He's got great reports, and he's a great coach. I mean, he's got a YouTube channel, and you're going to learn definitely from him. So how do they get a hold of you if they want to book a trip?
I'll just go to my Jimmy Eastling Fishing Facebook page and send me a message to get more information. I had a couple, just over the weekend, I had a couple people cancel due to some, like, you know, just personal deals, and they're rescheduling. So I got some dates later in the month that's going to be open for sure. But my Jimmy Eastling Fishing Facebook page is the best way to contact me.
Okay, Jimmy, as always, love when you call in. Be careful out there. Watch out for the eclipse tomorrow. We're looking forward to next Sunday.
Yes, sir. Man. Y'all watch out, too. I'm going to go out and try to catch some fish tomorrow during this thing. I think they're going to be eating.
Yes. Barometric pressure is going down. It's going to get dark. We're going to have a buzz bait by, baby. Hey, thanks, Jimmy.
Hey.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. Y'all have a good day.
Thank you, buddy.
You know, I was going to ask whether or not the eclipse was going to have any sort of added benefit for a fisherman if they decided to go on the water tomorrow.
Well, why not even try, Bonner Brand? You got to go out there.
Might as well go.
Real quick, before we get to Dana, you got one report you want to pop out?
No, I'll go ahead and go to Dana, and then whenever we get back, we'll take care of everything.
All right, let's get Dana on.
All right, we'll go right here. You've seen and heard Big Sarge over the years give tips on how to catch all sorts of fish, and he's proven it in tournaments. Now he's using his expertise in a different way, radio interviews. This is Reeling Them In with Big Sarge.
All right, Miss Dana, former Razorback softball player, which I love to watch, by the way. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing great. Thanks for having me this morning.
So I got a call from Garrett Morgan yesterday, and he said, you got to have her on, man. She's awesome. She takes care of animals, especially when, you know, when we go to Lake Fork a lot, you know, I'm stuck with both my dogs. I got a blue heeler and then a little whatever kind of dog. And, you know, you worry about stuff like that.
Kind of dog.
Yeah. Well, you worry about places when you drop them off where they really get taken care of and stuff. So tell us a little bit about you and what you got.
Yeah. So I, along with a couple of my business partners, we own a dog daycare boarding facility called the Rowdy Rough House. We've actually been working on this project for about 6 years. So we were really excited to finally get the doors open in February, and we are located in Maumelle, and our address is North Little Rock, but we're basically Maumelle, and so we provide 7 days a week daycare where your dogs, you can drop them off, and they can come play. We also have boarding, which are our overnight stays, and so for you guys and girls that are going out on fishing tournaments on the weekends or during the week and, you know, need a place to take your pups and you want to feel good about where they are, we will make sure that we love them well and that they're well taken care of and they've got plenty of room to come play with other dogs. And so, yeah, it'd just be a place for y'all to have a worry-free trip. And I know all about traveling and being busy and needing a place to take my dog. And so that's what we're here for.
Well, it does take some relief off people. You know, if you're listening right now, she'll give your information. I will say this. I have a heeler that there's a place that I dropped them off when we go on vacation, right? and he loses weight and stuff. And so, you know, the stress of you just don't really understand how much your dog doesn't want to be away from home. And so I'm hearing some good things about, you know, you take care of them and you do what you're supposed to do to kind of keep these dogs engaged.
For sure. Yeah. I mean, we treat them like family. You know, my dog is, anyone that knows me knows that I basically treat my dog like a human. But he, you know, we treat everyone's dogs like family here, and we love them, and we want to make sure that you guys can go on vacations or just go out, you know, for a day running errands or whatever you need to do and not have to worry about your dogs. And so that's what we're here for. We definitely are dog people. And, yeah, we're just blessed to be able to take care of y'all's pups.
Okay. A little history on you, Miss Dana. You play for the Hogs when?
Years and years ago. I was a Razorback. Well, I grew up in Texarkana, so I've kind of always been a Razorback, but I played for the U of A from 2004 to 2008.
Well, we have a third baseman right now. I live in BB. I've seen it on Facebook. Mm-hmm. I really think she's from McGray, whatever. That's only a mile down the road.
Oh, Hannah Gamble.
That's right. That's right. And
love her.
Yes. Yeah. You know what? If you can, you need to help me out and get a cell phone and see if she'll call in. That'd be pretty cool. I actually have
She would love that.
Yes, I would love for her to call in. Okay, so real quick, we got to go. Tell everybody how to get a hold of you to book your dogs.
Okay. Honestly, the easiest thing to do is we have a mobile app that you can download for Android or iPhone, and it's called Rowdy Rough House. So you can download that app. You can create an account. You can make reservations, upload shot records, and we're constantly uploading pictures throughout the day. You can put any add-ons or special, you know, treats that you want to do for your dog while they're here. So really the easiest thing to do is download our app.
Okay. Questions? Hey, everybody good?
I've got one. Well, I had one question, but I know we need to move along. I was just going to say, Dana, don't let Sarge fool you. The only dog he's worried about is the hot dog on his plate. Mm-hmm.
Man, what do you have to go there for?
We don't have any hot dogs here. We've got a lot of dachshunds here, but not any edible hot dogs.
Good. All right. Hey, listen, thank you again, and we'll stay in touch, believe me.
Okay. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Miss Dana. All right, let's do the weather, then we're going to go to Captain Frank.
It's going to rain.
We can give you tips on how to catch all sorts of fish, but if the weather doesn't cooperate, all those plans can go right out the window. So what will the weather be like this week? It's time for a check of Central Arkansas weather here on Fishing Arkansas.
Finally, today it's going to be 80. Tomorrow, 82 with a low of 55. Tuesday, 66 with a low of 60 with rain.
Mm.
Wednesday, 65, low of 56 with rain. Thursday, 70, low of 50. It's going to rain Thursday as well. Friday, 74, low of 45. Saturday, it comes back up to 78, low is 51. And Sunday, 77, low of 60.
Pretty what
cool
if?
Gulf Shores.
Yes, what if we want to go there?
We're going to Gulf Shores today. They're lower than us, 77 today. Monday, 63. Tuesday, 65. Wednesday, 68 with rain. Thursday, 57. Friday, low of 52. Saturday, low of 55. And Sunday, low of 60.
All right, it makes sense that we have Captain Frank. He's actually on the water right now fishing tournament. Let's get him.
There are plenty of Arkansans who go to the Gulf Coast on vacation. Just wear a Razorbacks t-shirt. You'll find out how many friends you have. You want to go fishing while you're down there, right? Well, we got just the guy who can help you out. It's time for a saltwater report with Captain Frank of Coastal Blue Persuasion. Check them out on Facebook or online at coastalbluepersuasionfishing.com. You can also call them at 251-513-4019. But that phone call can wait because we've got Captain Frank right now on Fishing Arkansas.
All right, Captain Frank, tell me what you're doing.
We're catching a few speckled trout this morning. Got some guys from Texas on this corporate tournament, and not the best bite in the world, but if you get in the right spot, they're hitting it about every time.
Well, having you out there is a plus for sure. How far are you away from the bank?
We're actually fishing some marsh.
Okay.
Almost in Mississippi, but we're about 8 miles from Dolphin Island.
Okay. All right.
We stayed in shore today.
We got a lot of folks that are headed down, especially May, June, and July. And you could book Sea Oaks West. There's a house there at Fort Morgan. Remember that, Sea Oaks West. And it sleeps up to 11 or 12 or 13, something like that, Captain Frank. He is a personal friend of you, and then they can book you. So how do they book a trip with you? And tell us a little bit about your boat.
Yep, got a 24 contender, and we'll go offshore, near shore, and inshore like today. And all they got to do is call me at 251-513-4019. And my son and his buddy are out fishing a different tournament, and they caught 52 redfish yesterday morning in one little spot. So when it's on, it's really good, but you got to grind and find.
All right. Well, it's always nice to have a saltwater report, and you're the best out there. Captain Frank, be careful out there, and looking forward to next Sunday.
Thanks, Frank.
All right. Don't burn your eyes tomorrow.
That's right. See you, buddy. All right. All right, let's go to Bobby Joe. What you got for me?
Hey, man, I'm just telling you, me and my buddy, we're going to Grenada Thursday and Friday or Friday and Saturday. If I don't catch a 2.5-pound crappie, I ain't never coming back. So I'm just telling you, it might be the last time you ever hear from me.
Bonner, you've been down there, hadn't you?
I've never been to Grenada, but that is one of the top crappie fishing.
Yes, sir. There's some hogs in there, and we're going to use our crappie expertise without the live scope, and we're going to bring home some hogs, man. I'm telling
you. Well, if you'd use live scope, you'd catch a 4-pounder instead of a 2.5.
Cheap. All right, man.
Thank you, Bobby Joe. Tell us the next week when you get back. All right. You want to knock out a report before we go on break?
Yeah, let's do that. Let's go to Greer's Ferry right now. The walleye are doing what they usually do this time of the year, following the river spawn, looking to get set back up down lake where they're going to fatten back up. But right now is a good time to catch them, cranking on the points and that sort of thing. There's always going to be fish moving up in and out right now this time of the year, as well as any other fish out there. They don't all spawn at the exact same time. But right now we've got post-spawn, pre-spawn, and spawn going on. For the walleye, it is a really great time to go up there and catch them up the rivers, get after it. The crappie are moving up into the shallow brush. Go get in that 10, 11, 12 foot brush and stand in timber and pick them off. It's a really good time to get up there with, monkey milk or natural shad colors, that sort of thing. That's really working well. And then the bass, look, man, you can catch them anywhere from, rolling a little Kitec down the edge of the brush, buck brush, all the way out to, dragging a Carolina rig out in 8 and 10 feet of water. This is the time of the year to get out and get up there and get after them.
You need to get out today and tomorrow for sure. We got 5 inches of rain. They claim, Bass Assassin, they claim 5 inches. All right, we got to go on break. Be right back to Fishing Arkansas. Rain coming.
A lot of rain.
Yours is really loud. Okay, so hey, let's talk a little bit about Facebook real quick. Let's talk about YouTube channel. Fish with Big Sarge YouTube channel. I did a 16-minute video from Lake Fork. I'm learning. All I have is a Tacticam. I ain't got my GoPros yet. It's a little expensive, to be quite honest. But I got a free Tacticam, so I'm trying to utilize it. There's an edit box out there that you can edit it, and so that was an 8-hour day, and we turned it into 16 minutes. It's very hard to do. Yesterday I took Sean out on Arkansas River. We fished for two and a half. My best five was maybe 10 pounds. Started out with a 3-pounder pretty quick, caught a lot of little bucks, but they're right on the bank, like you said. So here's this deal. Today at 12 o'clock at Leap Motorsports, they're having like a stereo off where you who's got the loudest stereo.
Yeah.
They claim that they've got stereos that will blow your back window out, that if you cranked it, it'll blow it out.
100%.
Huh. So let me talk about them real quick. They're the ones that did my truck. They have a truck build off going on right now between them and AC Sports. Bob Bottom Dollar Waller, Mark McClarty Ford gave each one of them a truck with an allowance, and we're going to see who wins.
Wow.
I can tell you that I've already seen AC Sports, and now I've already seen part of Elite Motorsports, and Elite Motorsports going to blow them away.
Really?
Oh, boy. Oh, boy. But anyway, I'm getting, I have two 10s with 800 watts underneath my back seat, and it's okay. Love the base. But I noticed they did a buddy of mine's, Winkle's truck, and so now I'm getting, is it called Fosgate?
Yeah.
I'm getting replaced with 800 watts in the doors. That's what I'm getting done, not next week, but the week after. I love music.
Can we turn That's her cool. headphones down?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. Which ones they
are so that I'm not. Look where I have them.
I know it's not the first one. That's me.
That's better.
Everything at about a three. Or
That's
maybe
better. Maybe it's
Sometimes the commercials get recorded. Live.
They're probably about to explode.
I'm good on mine.
Okay. Time to switch back, everyone. Drop them.
It's where the big boys come to play.
This is madness! This is Sparta!
103.7 The Buzz, KABZ Little Rock.
Action fishing trips on Lake Greeson, here's Dustin Holmes.
All I need to know is, are you fishing tomorrow during the eclipse?
Oh, yeah. We're fishing
good.
Right now.
Good. I knew you were out there right now, so tell me what's going on.
Oh, well, I'm waiting on this sun to pop out. I need it to come out. It's still kind of, you know, wind blowing, kind of cloudy. It looks like it's going to storm, but it's not raining. So the wind's blowing pretty good, a lot more than I thought it was going to this morning.
Yeah, listen, Dustin, Tuesday night we fished a tournament. We got a little check, third place. I think there's 31 boats. 43-mile-an-hour gust. I'm not sure I've seen the wind blow this much in the state of Arkansas. It blew yesterday. It ain't as bad today, but it's still 15 to 20. Let me ask you something real quick. We just had a phone call from Bobby Joe, and he's going Lake Grenada. Mm-hmm. And he said, I ain't using no live scope. Don't need it. Why don't you explain just how important a live scope is?
We got two big ones on. Let me net these. Get them in the net. Right there. Get that net. Okay. There we go.
Live action at its best. Live action, baby. We love it. Are you kidding?
No, we got them both in. So.
Okay. No. Are y'all using a live scope right now?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Well, we're a fishing pile. But you know, we're using a live scope to line all these guys up to cast that pile.
All right. So,
we're good. We got them. I'm back with you.
Good. Good. So
that was fun.
Yeah, that was fun. That was a good one. Were they good ones?
Yeah. Well, one was, probably 10 3/4. The other one's just an eater, about 12 inches.
Yeah, let's talk about eaters real quick. When you catch females that's got eggs, do you try to tell everybody, let's put it back? What do you do?
No, everybody here is going to, you know, like I said, everybody comes and wants to keep their fish. So.
Yeah.
Well, if it's a big one, you know what I'm saying, we'll try to release it. But, you know, 1.5 to 1.75, all those we pretty much keep.
Right.
You know.
So real quick, talk to me about tomorrow. You got trips. Everybody's wanting to go out there. While you're fishing, are you preparing them with the right glasses and all that good stuff?
Yeah. Tomorrow, I'm just going to do a half day. So that's supposed to happen a little bit after lunch.
Yep.
But I'm going back out fishing, that evening. So, but yeah, I'll have those, they have them down here at the marina for sale, those little glasses to use.
Okay. Okay. Dustin, we have the old general on after you. So real quick, they want to book a trip. I know you got four boats now. How do they do this?
they can call me. This is my cell phone number. A lot of times I don't have service on this lake, so if I don't answer, just leave me a message. When I get off the water, I'll call you. Number's 870-828-0605, or they can go online to actionfishingtrips.com. They can view all the calendars and everything like that. We have lodging available, so you can come down and stay the night before and then get up and go fishing. I guess crappie fishing, I'll go over kind of how we're catching them. Shallow brush piles to the bank. So staging piles, and then we're catching some on the bank. If you're going to catch them off the bank, the second part of the day is key. The bank bite is way better in the evening than it is in the morning. So in the mornings, I fish piles, and the evenings, I fish the bank. So maybe that'll help some people.
It does. It does. And just to let everybody understand that it really means a lot to have guides call the show. Our numbers came out, and 115,000 is the listeners, 32,000 is viewers, and it's because I have talent in the studio, and I have talent that's calling the show. So, again, thank you, Dustin, for calling the show, and we appreciate what you're doing.
Thank you all for having me.
See you, buddy. Good luck.
Thanks.
So how about we go from that talent to this talent?
It's very rare that we get to welcome a legend here on Fishing Arkansas. Well, Sarge is one in his own mind, but that's beside the point. We're talking about a man who was the first Bassmaster millionaire, a man who was consistently in the top five of the Angler of the Year standings, a man simply known as the General. Sounds like someone you could learn a few things from, right? Well, you're in luck, because it's time for Tricks of the Trade with Larry Nixon on Fishing Arkansas.
Good morning, Larry.
Good morning, guys. How's everybody down there?
Oh, Larry, the wind's still blowing. Let me tell you something, Larry. Tuesday night, we had a Tuesday night tournament. 30-something boats showed up. We got to check. We had 13 pounds, but it was 43-mile-an-hour gust. I'm not sure. Where are you at right now?
I'm sitting in the bedroom looking out in the field at a big old gobbler.
Oh, okay. So you're not. I thought you were fishing. I was wrong, Carolina
Reed.
No,
no. Not when it blows like this. I've turned into a fair weather fisherman, Sarge.
So,
I would say you've earned it.
Yeah. Bonner Brown's been knocking out some reports. We got some reports from Dustin. We got our saltwater. We know what the Arkansas River's doing. They're actually on their beds. What do you think a man and a girl needs to do when they go to Grish Ferry right now?
Well, I have two or three baits that I would for sure have on, and one of them's a little shaky head with a little 5-inch or 5 or 6-inch worm, preferably the little Yamamoto Sensi. I would darn sure have a Senko wacky rigged, and if you're going smallmouth fishing, put you a Ned rig on there with a little light 16th-ounce head on it, and set the boat in about 6 to 10 and kind of parallel the bank, because the lake is still low. I think they're still drawing water out of it for some blooming reason, and there's not hardly any water in the bushes. So everything is either sitting right in front of the bushes. And the key thing is, so you better have a little angle to the bank. Flat stuff is no good.
Okay.
That's unusual. And let me tell you, when I go in a pocket, and I went into a bunch of them this week, and I'm sitting in 5 foot of water and throwing the bushes are over there 20 yards away, or they ain't no fish there. I mean, you better be sitting in 10, 12, 15 foot of water on a bank that's got some angle to it, because they're just not using the flat water yet.
Okay. Good tip. The Arkansas River's a little different. You know, I was concentrating on, like you said, I was looking for flat places with grass, because they were behind the grass. I was wanting to ask you a little bit something about your boat. You know, you got it rigged up with forward-facing sonar, right?
Yes.
Okay, so we had a guy call in. He's headed down to Grenada, and he doesn't believe in the live scope. He's not going to use it. I need Larry Nixon's opinion about this.
Well, let me tell you one thing. If he's going to Grenada, he might as well not even go if he ain't going to live scope, because let me tell you something, that water over there is always muddy. And it is very difficult to fish it if you can't pinpoint the bait and the fish on that lake. It's way different than say our Arkansas lakes, where you can hunt up a brush pile or a treetop and go fishing. Over there, they roam in that dirty water, and if you ain't looking around, you're in trouble.
See,
I mean, that's just a fair opinion. I mean, I keep up with Grenada a lot because they catch a lot of 3-pound crappie over there, and they also throw them back. You know, they're big and they're females, and they throw them back. So, you know, that's their game over there, is catching big crappie. And all of them I know that are successful on Grenada, mostly 90% of them do it with forward-facing sonar.
Okay. Well, that's a Larry Nixon's report right there. Okay, what are you doing tomorrow for the eclipse?
Well, I don't know. The weather's not supposed to be the best in the world. I think it's going to blow again, and I really don't have anything planned. I've been laughing at this ordeal for about a month now.
I have
and
too.
I'm not seeing it. Leland fished all day yesterday on Greer's Ferry, and he said there was less boats there than he's ever seen in his life. So evidently the tournament decided not, that was a bad day to fish, so he really had a good day. And I went, let's see, yesterday was Saturday. I went Friday, and it was the same way. I was like, man, all these campsites are booked, and I only see two or three campers. I don't know, Sarge. It's kind of weird.
Well, if you listened to me last week or the week before, I said, prove me wrong. We're blowing this up too much. And I get it. I mean, maybe there's going to be a lot of traffic tomorrow once it's over. Everybody's hightailing it out of here. But 1.5 million is what they're expecting. And they've got porta potties on the highway. I ain't seen it yet, Larry, but maybe it's coming.
I haven't seen it, and it's really not in my forecast. But, you know, it's a big deal because it's coming dead center over the top of us. And I will say this, that it's cool. I've seen it before, partial. But, you know, to me, it's just another period of darkness, and we see that every evening about 7:30, 8 o'clock or somewhere in that neighborhood, and it's not a big deal to me.
Well, you're right, Larry, but like you said, now Japanese folks have booked half of Heber Springs, so there is some folks here. We know they didn't bring boats. They're all camping. They're all in the hotels, but Larry, as always, thank you. I put out some numbers earlier, and it's because I have such this great talent that calls the show. I am going to call you later on. I got something to ask you about Bass Pro Shop, but thank you again, Larry, and be careful tomorrow if you're on the water.
All right, girls and guys. I tell you right now, fishing is good right now. I'm sitting here looking at a big old dogwood tree in full bloom out here in my field, and darn it, I ought to be on the lake, but that wind is like, it's a howling.
You ain't lying, it's howling. All right, Larry, thanks.
And the water temp's still cold now at Greer's. It's still 58, 59 degrees, so our best fishing is just fixing the bust.
Yeah, me and Bonner was talking about that. I know we hit some 70s. Yesterday we tapped on 80s, but it's still getting down in the 40s at nighttime. Yep. So
the water temperature does not rise when the nights are cold.
Say, Carolina Rick, I told you that earlier. Okay, Larry.
All right, guys.
Thank you, Larry.
Thank you. All right,
buddy.
Have a good day.
See you, buddy. Let him knock out another report before we go on break.
Let's go at the Bull Shoals. The bass are in full-fledged pre-spawn right now up in Bull Shoals, and it's been really good. It's a good time to catch them. If it's super windy like it is today, get up close to the bank and throw, you know, power fish. Throw you a wiggle wart, throw you a rock crawler, throw a chatterbait, throw a spinnerbait, do something like that. There's a lot of guys catching them, you know, on the secondary points with jerk baits and over the top of brush and that sort of thing. My personal favorite is the Mega Bass Vision 110. I think that's the best jerk bait on the planet. Mm-hmm. You know, these fish right now, they're doing a lot of moving. They're chasing around fish. They're pre-spawn. They're feeding up. They're fattening up. So it's a good time to catch them. They're trying to eat right now. You know, single kitecs are working really good up there around bait fish. The walleye spawn is going on the lower sections of the lake. I know we're harping on the walleye spawn. A lot of people want to hear about that, though.
Yes, they do. We don't do enough of it.
The lower lake section, man, they're starting to see them on the main lake points at night. If you're fishing for them during the daytime, go shallow until the sun gets up, and then you got to start backing off into that 20-foot range. Those fish don't like the sunlight. They like to get low. They like the low light conditions, so they're always going to go deeper as soon as that sun starts breaking. Shallow diving jerkbaits, just like normal at night.
All right, good report. We got more of those coming. Now, what do you cook tomorrow for the eclipse?
So you followed all the advice you've heard here on Fishing Arkansas, and you caught all the fish you wanted. Now you've brought them home, cleaned them up, and you don't know what to do with them. Do you think we'd really leave you hanging there? Come on now. You know what's better than that. It's time on Fishing Arkansas for a little segment we like to call Cooking with Big Sarge.
I want to know about moon pies. That's got to be huge.
You know what? Katie bought some moon pies for the eclipse.
Say,
really?
Say.
Yes. Here's the crazy part. She's never had a moon pie.
Really?
Oh, no. They're delicious.
I know.
I used to love them.
My sister posted a post on Facebook yesterday. She put together little goodie baskets for her two kids for tomorrow. Moon pies, cosmic brownies, star crunches, the whole bit.
That's fun.
Well, you got some stuff.
So I would say most of the food that we're looking for the eclipse stuff is stuff like tailgating stuff. But moon pies is one of them. That's super cool. I saw on Facebook a little sweet shop in Conway. Julie's sweet shop is right off the interstate. And she's making the cutest eclipse cookies. So my daughter has 15 family members coming in from Iowa. And I said, hey, Emily, do you want me to go get your family some of these cute eclipse cookies? So
that's a good mom.
They are really, really neat cookies. Go check them out right off the interstate in Conway.
Okay. All right. I'm not sure what anybody out there is having for the lunchtime, but whatever, huh?
We know Sarge is going to be big on a hot dog.
I've got me some Nathan hot dogs. I'm going to grill them up. I sure am, with some cheese dip. And I'm gonna polish it off with a Budweiser. No, I'm kidding. I don't do Budweiser.
He's not kidding.
Yeah. So we're coming back with Prove Me Wrong. I got something good. It's about Skeeter boats. Y'all stay with us, Fishing Arkansas.
Oh boy.
Oh, Larry.
I'm gonna do my best to be nice on this whole.
Well, listen to me out first.
I will hear you out.
Hear me out, and then you know, since you're not in one right now, so there's Larry.
How much wiring did I have to fix on your boat to make it work right? That was done at the factory.
Yeah, I know. Right. But I'm just saying, let's go with other stuff. So just bear with me. Just bear with me. Larry just sent out a nice picture.
It does go really fast. Bonner, it goes really fast.
They run good. You know, they're 70 mile an hour boat.
Yeah.
They're 70 mile an hour boat. That Phoenix will run out of his life, though.
Yeah. What's Rick Carter's? Phoenix.
Yeah. It's a good ride boat.
I will just recommend a few things. And Rick Carter said that they actually make them, but those boats need heated seats. I know. Y'all think that is so funny, but that they need heated seats on them, heated steering wheel. But listen, they need grip handles on the seats.
They're like, on there.
No, on the sides of the seats.
They're on there. They're on the Phoenix.
They're on there.
You got one underneath here and one right here.
Well, did you not? You don't need to lean forward and go under.
No, did you not look at the side of the seat? Right, it's got two big wings right there.
Well, Skeeter does. I'm not sure Phoenix did.
Phoenix does too.
Oh, they do.
Yeah.
Well, I see one over here. There's something under there, but it's like
when
your legs are stretched out and you're hanging on because it feels like 120 on the water.
Was you in in the boat, or was it Basil? I don't remember when we took out and the birds were there and you had to make a left. Was that you?
That was me because I videoed it.
So we were. I've never seen that on the lake before. Millions.
Yes.
Of these birds, big ones, you couldn't go through them. Rick had to do a 180, and I did a 180 because you couldn't go through them. They were too slow getting up.
Yeah. You would have hit them. that was a fun, and I have that on video if you want it. Pretty cool. Tons of birds.
Yeah, you need to put that out. I don't know why you didn't.
Well, I still can't figure out how to post on the live. But I could post it on your fishing page.
I don't think we can post on the live. I mean, I know we can write comments and that sort of thing.
But you
as
can
far
just
as like
comment.
Posting pictures.
Can you not just go to comment and put, add it on there?
No, it won't let you.
Well, the wind is blowing again.
And I just say, every time I hear the Sissy's Log Cabin ad, I love it because they have a line of Lagos, and it is caviar jewelry.
You working on a bank?
No.
You're supposed to be working on a bank.
No, you didn't tell me that. Give me.
No, you're supposed to be working on a bank for us. Here.
Oh, I'm in fishing mode, okay? All I could think of is fishing on the bank.
I told Leslie, that's the marketing manager here, that you were going to try to get a hold of them, and she said that they already sponsor some of the stuff here. She goes, so it may be an easy one. Yeah. Yep.
Okay. They need to be.
All right, so what are we doing when we come back?
Prove me wrong.
Okay. Here we go.
Need help? Ask Homer at any of locations, Searcy, Beebe, or Cabot.
Had the feeling that you just know something for an absolute fact, only to be told differently? Do you still hold on to that belief even after being told differently? It happens to Big Sarge all the time, so much so, we're making it a segment on the show. It's time for Prove Me Wrong on Fishing Arkansas.
So, Bonner Brown, I don't have a ton of people that disagree with me, but we do have people that are sponsored by other boats, and so they're not going to say anything because they're actually getting a free boat. But here's my deal, and, you know, gets it, Haney, that fished Tuesday night with me, it was 43 mile an hour. There were swells out there. He never got a stitch of water on him. And he said, I will say that I've been in a lot of boats, and your Skeeter by far rides the best. I know you agree on that part. Skeeters, their first boat was 1948.
Yes.
And let me just say this. Setting the standard, raising the bar, leaving the rest of the boating industry in the wake of our innovation, right? The big question is, do they hold their value? Because when you get a boat, you want to step up or you want to trade it in. The brand reputation for reliability contributes to the attractiveness of a used Skeeter. Skeeter boat composite. Explain that to everybody, the composite.
So the fiberglass work. That's what they're talking about as far as composite. There's no wood in the boat anywhere. It's all 100% either aluminum or fiberglass. There's...
Production process uses advanced manufacturing techniques and materials, many of which were used in aerospace applications. Do you understand that, Carolina Rig?
Mm-hmm.
The construction ensures, of course, a smooth and safe trip. Let me put this out. Somebody's going to say, well, you're saying that because you're sponsored by Skeeter Boats. Well, I'm sponsored by Greg Orr Marine, but let me explain to you. I went to them. Okay, I knew what was the best boat. If I thought this other boat was the best one, I would go to them and try to sell myself. That's how you, young ones out there, that's how you get a sponsor. Don't take a sponsor that wants to throw you materials or whatever, and you don't really believe in what they have, because you're not going to be a true believer of that company. Am I right?
I agree. You know, we do have a lot of people out there that are sponsored by a certain group, and it's their job to represent that brand.
That's
and represent it to the best of their abilities. So by them taking that boat and showing people what it's capable of and so on and so forth and talking good about the product. You know, that's their job. That's what they're supposed to do. You know, you went and got your Skeeter. You chose that route. So I have to say that, you know, your weight or your words mean more in that aspect. You know, we see a lot of boats day in, day out. We are inside and out of them. And, you know, we did see some just straightforward. I'm not going to pull any punches. I'm going to speak exactly the way I see it. And some mm-hmm. people like it. Some people don't. It is what it is. Whenever the COVID era of production, we saw a lot of issues.
Mm-hmm.
You know, top to cap separating. Now, it wasn't just with Skeeter. It was with a lot of different boats.
Mm-hmm. And it was because you think they were trying to put them out fast?
It was that, and they didn't have the workforce to make sure that things were done correctly okay. and right. Now, Skeeter has always had a really good warranty system, as far as I know. And if I have to say that, I think there's probably more Skeeter boats out there than there is any other brand.
Yeah.
You know, being owned by Yamaha and having that, you know, that relationship with a top-notch motor company, I think Yamaha is probably the best-built motor on the planet, and it comes right on that Skeeter.
I'll end it with this. I won't preach a lot because we have Long Shot Lil on here. That whether it's my name or this show or whatever, Tuesday night showed a lot of folks that there's a lot of Skeeters out there now, and we have a lot of our friends that have traded in their boats for a Skeeter.
Yeah,
and you know, they're not huge names. Our Scott Suggs of the world, Larry Nixon's of the world, they're sponsored by a boat.
Yes.
Okay, and they're paid to talk about that boat.
Yeah.
But I promise you, and I know this for a fact, there are pros out there that are sitting on a Skeeter inside their garage that is that's their boat.
Yeah, absolutely, and Skeeter is a well-built boat.
Yeah.
I have to say, as far as fit and finish and glass work and that sort of thing, there is a company out there that beats the socks off everybody else. I'm not going to, you know, rain on your parade at all, but we run our hands on the inside of a lot of boats.
Yeah.
And there's one clear winner.
Okay. Okay. Well, let's leave it right there.
He started the prove me wrong, didn't he?
Yeah, I think I did okay, didn't I?
You did good. Okay. And I love the Skeeter boats.
Thank you. And you was in both of them. I'm not going to lie to you. There is nothing wrong with the Phoenix boat.
Nope.
Love them. Do you want to make some money today?
Sure, I always like to make money.
All right.
She's a handicapping prodigy, and just like any good horse, like Secretariat, Smarty Jones, or any of the others, her bloodline is top-notch. She comes from good stock, I guess you could say. Now she's turning her attention to the live racing meet at Oaklawn Racing Casino Resort in Hot Springs. Grab a sheet of paper and a pen, because it's time for Long Shot Lil's Oaklawn Picks on Fishing Arkansas.
Good morning, Long Shot. Listen, had a beautiful birthday party without you. I'm sorry you missed it at Texas Roadhouse. We had a great time. Your mom got up on that little old pony and rode it. So,
oh, that's nice.
It is nice. So tell me, how do we win money today?
Okay, so I think y'all should place some bets on these horses that I'm about to tell y'all.
Okay.
And you should probably make some money.
Bring it.
So in race number one, we have number 8, Tiff with Jimmy. In race number 2, number 1, Tava. In race number 3, number 2, Chupapi Moon Yo.
Chupapi! Sorry.
In race number 4, number 3, Greer's Ferry.
What's the chances? Go ahead.
In race number 5, number 4, Pam Pam. In race number 6, number 11, Honey Run. In race number 7, number 6, Master of Arms. In race number 8, number 9, Edge to Edge, and that's the long shot. And then last one, race number 9, number 5, Mystery Mo.
There's your picks, ladies and gentlemen. That's Longshot Lil. Listen, Longshot, tomorrow for the eclipse, are you out of school?
I am.
Okay, well, listen, you be careful and wear them glasses. You hear me?
I will.
Okay. Give your mom a hug. See you later.
I will. Thank y'all.
See you later. Bye.
And since we're on the subject of horse racing for just a moment, you had a couple of stakes races at Oaklawn yesterday. Patron's Tizzy, the winner of the Rainbow Stakes. And I especially like the name of this horse that won the Rainbow Miss. Hush It, Honey.
Hush It, Honey. Hey, by the way, Lotto is $1.3 billion. When are they pulling that again?
That is apparently 3 days a week. So I think they pulled Monday, last Wednesday, night. Friday. I don't know if
I think they had some sort of issue with the drawing last night. So whatever the next scheduled day is, I believe, is when they'll draw for that.
Monday.
And the jackpot will probably grow from that.
Monday, Wednesday, Saturday?
I believe that's it.
You need to look that up, by the way. Listen, y'all got time for a football player? Arkansas.
You've seen and heard Big Sarge over the years give tips on how to catch all sorts of fish, and he's proven it in tournaments. Now he's using his expertise in a different way, radio interviews. This is Reeling Them In with Big Sarge.
What do you say, number 97?
Big Sarge, what's the deal?
Man, let me tell you something. I want to first apologize that I hadn't got you on the water. You know, I'm still full-time at Camp Robinson. That is coming to an end about 6 months. But we are going to take care of you, but this is what I want to know. I want to know what's going on up in the hill. And am I going to see a lot of you coming up in the season?
Yes, sir. Everything looking well on the hill. It's just a matter of everybody coming together. We continuously practicing hard and working on building relationships and running plays, and everything rolling right. Going down the right path.
I will say
that. For me on the other end, I've been running with the 2s and 1s, so I feel I got a lot of positive things going. It's just a matter of running the defense and running the plays and knowing where I'm supposed to be. But everything looking good on my end.
Of course it is. I mean, you're a beast. And I will say this: somebody wants to sponsor this segment, I ain't got no problem with that. Quincy Rhodes loves to fish, and he will knock that quarterback on his butt.
Oh, that's awesome!
I know it is.
Hey, quarterback.
hey, let me ask you this. I don't even know if you can even answer this. The quarterback situation up there, man, it's going to be a good one this year, isn't it?
Yes, sir. Like you said, I really can't answer it, but right now they're just battling for their positions right now at the moment.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of stuff that I can't step on, and I don't really know the rules of engagements, but I will say this. Quincy Rhodes is a stud. He's going to be there every Saturday when we're watching him. Real quick, you're 6'7", 6'8", what, 340?
I'm not old lineman, but I fluctuate between 280 and 290 every now and then, but I'm
6'7". I'm sorry, I was putting you a little, but you do run about a 4'5", don't you?
Probably low 4'7".
Okay. 4'7". Yes, okay. Listen, that you're incredible. Thank you for taking time, and I promise you, when you come back for break, I don't even know when your next break is, you call me, and we're going to get you on the water. Again, if y'all want to sponsor this, you want to hear Quincy every Sunday, then please jump on this. Man, this kid's going to be going to be playing for the Denver Broncos one day, I promise.
That would be amazing.
Yes, or
the
Cowboys.
Or the Cowboys.
Come on. Come on, somebody.
Have a heart attack if it was the Cowboys.
Sir. Yeah, no kidding. Listen.
Are y'all going to the spring game?
No, I won't be able to.
That's true. That is this coming Saturday.
It is?
The Cowboys spring game is?
No, the Razorback spring game.
Razorback?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's at 12 o'clock at the Big Stadium Saturday at noon.
I think the SEC channel will cover that, won't they?
I'm not sure. I'd have to double check on that.
Okay. Well, I'm looking forward to you planting some folks on their butts. So, listen, be careful up there. You're a good kid. I love you when you call in, and we're looking forward to getting you back on the line.
Yes, sir. I'll keep in contact. Actually, after the spring game, I'll probably head back down this way. So I'll probably be back in North Little Rock around 3 o'clock. I'm actually here now, but I'm visiting the family, but I'll probably end up doing that after the game. So maybe we could bump into each other.
All you got to do is call me, my man. Let's get you on there and see if you can catch one with a frog.
That That's awesome. All I'm right, proud good. Of you.
I'm going to get you to Lake Fork is what I'm going to do.
Please.
Yeah. Quincy, thank you again, brother.
Yes, sir. No problem anytime.
Thanks.
See you, bud. See you, bud. All right, Quincy Rhodes.
I'm sorry about that. Just a quick update. While you were on the phone with Quincy, we had a caller that called in. There was a technical issue with the draw last night for the Mega Millions or Powerball, whichever it was. They did wind up having the drawing last night. One winner in the state of Oregon.
Oh. Won the whole thing?
Won the whole thing.
Whoa. I mean, what is the chances? What is the chances to hit never number? Makes me ill. It wasn't me. Coming back with
If it had been you, we wouldn't have seen you this morning.
No, I would be hightailing somewhere, hiding, figure out how I'm going to spin it. Listen, camping spot, calendar events, back to the basics, Bonner Brown. We got all that coming up. Stay with us. Fishing Arkansas. Told her, I said, listen, first off, you don't let your name out because somebody's going to kidnap you. So the first thing you do is just hightail it, tell your close family where you're going. And then you got to, because it's a lump sum of $552 million.
After all of it.
Lump sum. Mm-hmm. So you then you got to figure out what you're going to do.
Get an attorney and an accountant and a bodyguard.
Yep. In that order.
Mm-hmm.
Don't put your name out there.
Don't tell anyone. Got to let this settle. It takes months to get all that in order. You seen those shows? Most of them all go bankrupt.
I mean, you got to be smart.
You
there's no way you can spend that. You could live off. Here's what a buddy of mine said. He got $1 million for selling his company. His attorney says you can live off the interest, which is $5,600 or something like that, just off the interest alone. He said, as long as
if you're getting a high enough yield on it, yeah.
Yeah, he said you never have to touch your million if you're not greedy. Well, that's just $1 million. So just think if you were $500 million.
I know. $1 million is not enough really to retire on, right? If you're retiring young, even if you just stay living off the interest, you're not buying extra stuff. You're living regular.
I'm ready to live regular as much as I've been through. So. Yeah. And like I said, I won't be rich, but I'll be able to chill and do whatever. I'm going to help my friend out here.
If you want to live regular, you might want to mix in some fiber. Quit eating them hot dogs.
I've never even seen him eat a hot dog, but everyone says hot dogs.
We just give him crap because he says he likes them. So, and he,
who you don't like see someone get, on the barbecue
and I'm
grill.
Being nice about it. Drop Shot will go savage on him.
I saw him go savage.
Don't make any sense to me.
Doo, 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 doo.
What about a bratwurst?
Huh?
Oh, I love a good bratwurst.
Oh. Yeah. No bun.
I know.
You know what's a good way to have a bratwurst?
How?
Not in the casing, but smash it like a hamburger patty.
Okay.
Pro move right there. You're welcome.
That was free.
That. My kids love bratwurst.
Where are you going after this?
Home.
I'm thinking about me some breakfast, and then Brad's out on the river, but he said wind is blowing.
Huddle House has solar eclipse little kits for kids, colors and
yeah. We need to talk about Huddle Chips.
And, they're just the coolest people. I mean, it helps they have seven
Could they
boys.
Possibly bring us some samples one morning.
They ain't gonna drive from Greenbrier down here. They sure aren't.
They are so busy. I don't even know how they get everything.
I'm sure Saturday and Sunday mornings are quite busy for them. I'm sure.
Yeah.
He did the right thing by putting it in Greenbrier.
Oh yeah. Well, you know, he's born and raised there.
It's just a cool little town.
His dad was one of the first football teams, and so that they really prominent. They did a huge photo of his dad, and they've been collecting the stuff for the decor for probably a year. But
that's weird.
I mean, it is booming. They hit a record. You know, we hit
records. Yeah.
Jason Everett's going to hit records. He hit the all-time record for the first week of any Huddle House ever in the nation.
Wow.
Well,
in Greenbrier.
How far is Clinton from Greenbrier?
20 minutes.
Yeah. I'd go 20 minutes for food.
Yeah.
I went to Lone Oak the other day to Grumpy Rabbit. You need to take Katie.
I've heard you talk about it a couple times.
Yeah. Not very far. Took us 20 minutes. It's two
Where's
story.
It
right downtown Lone Oak.
Lone Oak. Huh? Going camping?
Yeah.
Okay.
right downtown Lone Oak, and that's
conveniently located at 901 East 8th Street in downtown Little Rock.
Sometimes there's just nothing better than hitting the open road, finding a good camping spot, and hanging out with family and friends. But if your trailer's not working right, that could be a pretty short trip. That's why you need to go to Axles Plus. They're your go-to for all your trailer needs, located in BB at 2502 West DeWitt Henry Drive. And if you don't feel like roughing it, maybe you want the comforts of a camper or RV, check out Moik's RV with two locations in Conway, one in Springdale, and now they're open in Hot Springs Landing. However you choose to do it, we're here to give you the best camping spots on Fishing, Arkansas.
I want to say this first. Jumps on great people, Axles Plus and BB. Me and Bonner know them very well. Go get your hubs if you need to save yourself some time on the side of the road. And Mike Moitz is the man when it comes to RVs. Go
Kettle Camp Crown in Eureka Springs, one of my other favorite places. It's rated the top 10 in the state. They have bathhouses, pool, playground, and full hookups. Love Eureka Springs. Love, love, love.
I have not gone.
You
Shame
need to
on
go.
Me. They need to invite me so we can do a show up there.
We need to get you there, you and Sean. She would love that, too. She would love it. They're okay. Shopping there. It's like going back in time. I love it.
Going
love
back
it.
In time, I'll mm-hmm. tell you. You know, we're going to go back to the basics. Ring the bell. School's back in.
The crew on Fishing Arkansas prides itself on giving the most accurate information when it comes to anything related to fishing. But what if you're new to fishing and this all sounds like Greek to you? Well, we're about to drop some knowledge on you because we're going back to the basics on Fishing Arkansas.
Bank fishing.
Yeah.
So right now the trout fishing's hot and it's bank fishing. Lake Conway, it's hot. It's bank fishing. And if you're sitting there saying, I don't have a boat, don't want to buy a boat, ain't got money to buy a boat, I want to go bank fishing.
Yes.
Bonner Brown, talk to me.
So, you know, this time of the year, well, any time of the year, man, if you just want to go out and go catch fish, go get you some old red worms or night crawlers or some crickets or tuba crickets, get out there with a bobber and, you know, a couple feet of line hanging off the bobber on that thing.
It's so simple.
It's so simple. I mean, these fish, they're going to eat. You're going to go catch bream. I've caught everything from crappie, bass, catfish, brim on a red worm or night crawler.
A little safety tip right now, snakes are getting out and they're warming themselves. So when you walk down to the bank, just scan it.
Absolutely.
Scan it.
So, you know, and if you're not wanting to use live bait, maybe you're against using live bait. My wife, Katie, is 100% against using live bait.
I'm with her. No live bait in a skeeter.
No, sorry. Well, I'm going to dump a tube of crickets in there one day.
But don't they? Do not laugh at this. We're talking about basics. I've heard of people fishing with hot dogs. Is that
yeah.
Catfishing with hot dogs.
Yeah. You betcha. You could take hot dogs, cut them up, and put them in some special sauce and season it overnight. Bam.
Let's go back to what we were talking about.
Sorry.
I mean, you can get out there with a spinnerbait or, you know, something that's weedless that you don't have to worry about hanging up as much. Texas rig jig, not Texas rig jig, but a Texas rig or a jig, you know, something like that to where you can get out there, you can bomb a long cast and just slowly work that thing back. Something weedless that you don't have to worry about having to wait out there and get unhung. Those are really good things to throw.
So real quick, especially for somebody like Carolina Riggs' daughter's boyfriend, Sam.
Drew.
Mm-hmm. So here's the deal. You go to a place like Fishing Stuff or Bass Pro Shop and just go in there and say, listen, I'm going on the bank. I don't know. You're going to hear us talk about it, but like he just said, a Texas rig or a spinnerbait, maybe it's all foreign to you, but you're getting the tips. So write them down. Go to these two stores and say, I'm going bank fishing. Those guys, the reason why we're talking about them is because they're with us. They're family.
Yep.
And they'll help you out, right?
100%.
Okay. Since you're already got your throat going, let's get this.
Hey,
Having the latest technology is a way of life these days, so why should fishing be any different? But with all the equipment choices out there, it's hard to know what's best for your specific needs. You're in luck, though, because we've got just the man who can help guide you through it all. Bonner B is here with this week's technology report on Fishing Arkansas.
You want to talk about something on the back of your power poles.
Yeah, so I saw a comment today on the live feed talking about the little props that are on the power poles. So let's elaborate on that a little bit. It's called a C-brake system. There's a few companies out there that make them, but I really, really like C-Lite's version of it. They're built right there in Russellville. Good mm-hmm. night. It mm. took me forever to get that out. Built right in Russellville, mm-hmm. you know, so your customer service is there. If you do have any issues, it's local. Mm-hmm. That's something that's really neat about it. Doing business with a local company, especially someplace like C-Lite that stands behind their stuff.
Right.
If you have an issue, they're local. Take it to them or take it to the person like us that installed them and we'll help you out. So that being said, the C-brakes, you can lower your trolling motors that are on the power poles. You don't have to drop your power poles all the way down. You just to where the props are in the water.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're running up on a pile, you can hit your button, your stomp button, and you slow down your boat from the back of the boat instead of washing out your brush pile. So if I roll up on a brush pile and I'm too close to it,
mm-hmm.
I roll up on it and get up 20 feet off of it. I can hit those buttons and back up nice mm. and slow. I don't blow out my pile.
Mm-hmm.
It really helps with drift fishing or, spider rigging and that sort of thing.
Mm.
You can put your boat into the wind or a downwind going with the wind, and you can slow yourself down with those C-brakes. You can slow yourself down to where you're holding the right amount of speed to catch the fish that you're looking for, keep your baits at the right depth and that sort of thing. And whenever you are casting, hey, your back is downwind, so you can bomb that little crappie jig way out there.
So the power poles, let's just say, they're going to be $2,500 a piece, roughly?
$21.99 for blades. Now, there are cheaper options out there, yes.
All right, so let's just say you get them. Now, adding that will cost you what?
So I think the C-brake system comes in at about $1,400,
okay.
Which has a control module in the back of the boat. We want run one wire to the front that ties into a stomp switch, and it has a little power control knob up at the front that's connected to your graph. And it just really makes it a nice, seamless system. And all the control is done at the back of the boat where the trolling motors are. So we're not having to run an 6 gauge wire all the way to the front of the boat and then all the way back like we used to have to when we were doing something like this. There's a control module in the back of the boat that operates everything, so it makes our life a whole lot easier.
So, folks, if you're listening right now and you have a boat, you don't have any power poles, first off, and prove me wrong.
You don't need power poles. You don't have to have them.
Okay, but you don't need just one. You need two.
You need two.
Okay. Let's make that clear to everybody.
Yes, you do need two. Power poles are a great addition to the back of the boat. I used to be, fishing majority deep water lakes. It's like, I really don't need those.
Mm-hmm.
This last week down at Fork, I had them on the boat that I was down there in. They are indispensable.
Yeah, you're right.
You got to have them.
Love it. He put the stomp buttons on mine, which I never have. So that means when I go up to somewhere and I start fishing and I need to stop, I got to walk down to my steering wheel and hit them, or my partner does. Don't do that. They Bluetooth. It took him 5 minutes to do it.
That's it. It's super easy.
All right. Thank you very much for that.
Yeah. Oh, hey, PowerPole just released a new deal now, too, to where they're running both poles on one pump. So a lot of our older boats and that sort of thing that we don't have enough room to get two pumps into, well, power poles come up with a solution to that. To where,
genius.
It's awesome. It's great. I can't wait to install one of these things.
Looking Beast Outdoor Innovation. Get a hold of Bonner Brown right there fishing stuff.
That's right. You can look me up on Facebook. My phone number is on there. Hey, look, I ain't going to lie. I'm terrible about the Facebook Messenger thing. Call me.
Call.
Text me.
That's the best thing.
Just call me or text me.
Call him or Katie.
Don't call Katie.
Yeah,
she won't answer the phone
anyway.
Okay. All right.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Let's have some fun.
You know how you're going about your business on a daily basis, and then you see or hear something that just really bugs you?
You know, that really grinds my gears.
Hey, bro, come on now, dog. Come on, man.
Come on, man. What are we talking about?
Well, we're setting aside a little time to get these things off our chest. It's Come On Man on Fishing Arkansas.
Ooh, let's get it started.
Rick,
You know, I just talk about staying out of the fast lane, but today it's going to be stay out of the middle lane if you're cruising 68. Why are you even in the middle lane? There's nothing on the right of you. There's nothing on the left of you. Get in the slow lane.
Maybe it's smoother.
I don't care. Because when people like me come up behind you, I'm going to have to go right or go left.
You know what? I'm going to let you. I ain't moving.
I think now it's illegal to
get behind me.
Someone tell us if it's illegal to pass in the slow lane.
Man, I ain't got no love. If I'm pulling my boat, I'm in the left lane because it's so rough. Bonner, help me.
Yes. The right-hand lane, especially heading north on 167, is a booger.
Beat you to death.
It will beat you to death. It'll cause blowouts as well. And
is that all you got?
Well, I don't want to be over there then.
Yeah. Are you good?
Yeah.
That's all you got to grab about?
You just need to travel then when it's not busy time.
Okay, I'll do that.
Hey.
Bonnerby.
Look, I can get on board with what she's saying. I can't stand it when somebody's driving the speed limit in the fast lane. That is ticket money lane. Get out of the way.
Yes.
That's it?
No. That's not it. I can't think of anything. Honest to God, it's been a great week. We've been super busy.
Yeah.
Getting boats out. I have nothing to be mad about.
Nothing but love. I'm hearing all the way down to Texas. I'm telling you, I get phone calls. And listen, I don't work with them. One day I'm going to help them out a little bit. All right, I got this. Willow Beach. They finally put a floating dock there. Guess what? There's no way to get to it. They have two logs that you got to shimmy across to get to it. Come on, man. Aww. And then the second thing, are you kidding me, Bass Assassin? Men's championship of any kind, World Series, NFL, they're always what time? Nighttime.
Yeah.
Why in the world are you putting the girls at 2 o'clock on Sunday? I got that out.
Stressful.
Coming back with some bank on it. Y'all stay with Fish and Arkansas.
We might think about blending bank on it with back to the basics. So we're talking about the same stuff.
Yeah, I don't even know if we have time, to be honest with you. We don't.
Oh, it's 52.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Actually, what we're going to do is bank, safety, and rundown. Y'all both on rundown.
4.5.
4.5, so that means we need to spend 2.5 on rundown.
What's your safety?
Safety? Oh, it's a special. It's a special. Good show today. We're almost done. Went by quick.
Mm-hmm.
Good phone calls. I forgot to give the catfish report to Attorney General. Don't hate me.
Rick.
Rick's fishing that tournament, so.
In the wind.
Lake Lega Chips was going to try to call, but I don't blame him.
Why wasn't it? Did he sign this? Oh, he needs to sign this. Will you sign this in a hot pink?
Sign Rick's name?
No, your name. I'll get Rick to sign it next time I see him. I need an autographed. You're going to sign it too.
Okay.
Bonner. In hot
pink. So we're going right to that out of the break?
Yeah, I did safety brief.
I did.
And then the rundown.
I did.
What did I say, bank and then safety? Yeah.
Thank you.
Butter me! Sorry.
This is so nice.
Well, it usually goes to the biggest fish, which actually was Lee, with an 8 whatever.
He said I
But it is your personal best.
Mm-hmm. And probably most improved.
That doesn't sound.
That reminds me, I need to redo Rick's intro to include.
Yes. Did you know? I just noticed this in the movie. It may not be real, but that Fly Fisherman movie I've been watching twice, they keep their net in their pocket.
Yeah, they don't deal with as big a net as we do.
Well, yeah, but they have to. They ain't got no boat. Little. They're out fly fishing.
Yeah, they're kind of little. And what they're fly fishing with, is it a live bait?
No, they're called nymphs.
It looks like
eggs.
A bug on, laying on the water, mm-hmm. And the whole line is laying on the water.
Mm-hmm. They use a floating line with a leader. That's a really small line, so they'll have a leader about that long. So the fish is not paying attention to what's going on over here. All they see is this over here.
That might be 2-pound line, right?
I think 4 and 6 is
And you see it come up and take it
Don't get me wrong. I haven't gotten into it, but.
Time to switch back.
You probably need to try trout.
Oak Street Conway. We're on Facebook and Instagram.
I let it fall.
It's time to bank on it.
Yes, we're looking for a bank. It only makes sense, right, Carolina Reed?
Yes.
You want to bank fish right now for trout fishing. Little Red's on fire. Fly fishing with a double nymph. That's N-Y-M-P-H rig set with a egg pattern. That is happening. Now, I'm not a huge trout fisherman, Bonner B. Am I right?
You're right.
All right. All right, let's leave it at that. Y'all want to do a safety brief? Bring it on.
Yep. Hey, hold your ears for half a second. Do we have your attention now? Good. It's time for Big Sarge's safety briefing on Fishing Arkansas.
All right, we covered there's nobody out fishing during this eclipse, right? What if you're driving, Bonner B, and you're absolutely clueless to the time and it starts getting dark? Don't, for goodness sake, and hit somebody. That's my safety brief. All right? Don't freak out and hit the ditches.
That is a good question, though, because you're driving, but there's certain
times. I'm trying to help you.
There's certain times you got to have the glasses on and off.
Listen, if you're a senior citizen, especially you're going somewhere, don't freak out on me.
Just and actually, I think you only need the glasses if you're looking directly at the sun, trying to see the eclipse itself.
Yeah, it could bounce off somebody's mirror and hit you in the eyeball. I'm not sure. Let's hit this.
When we're not on the air, Big Sarge often says Fishing Arkansas is the fastest 90 minutes in radio. And to be honest, it does go by pretty quickly. But we do have a lot to cover still this morning and a little bit of time left in the show. So here's the rundown of what's left on Fishing Arkansas.
Globe Life.
Your cancer policy, it's time. Life, cancer, accident, critical illness, ICU. This is paying you cash in your pocket if something happens to you or your family. Mm. Pays your light bill, your car payment. Your health insurance isn't going to do that. Go look at supplemental benefits. They're insanely inexpensive.
Okay. Travs.
Travs are playing at 1:35 today. It's the last game of the season opening three-game series. Won Friday night, lost last night, so the rubber match today.
Hmm. Bonner B.
Yes.
Where do they find you, Bonner B?
So we are located at Fishing Stuff, 7473 Warden Road. Give me a call at 501-760-8990. And you can also call Fishing Stuff as well, and they will always bring the phone back to me, regardless if I'm upside down or not.
All right. Tuesday night tournament is every other Tuesday. The next one is not this Tuesday. It's the next Tuesday. You go to Fishing Stuff. It's $50. We will teach you boat and fishing etiquette if you don't know. We got some old heads out there, and I will say that if you cut me off, you'll know why. Okay. That's just what we're going to do. We're going to teach you.
I just make it a habit to cut him off regularly.
That's a good point.
And have your boat ready.
Hog Coach, we need a coach, baby. What you got for me?
Well, there are a couple of interviews that are set to happen today. Mississippi State's coach and Little Rock Trojans coach Darrell Walker are both scheduled for interviews today.
I want to say this. Would you please put a center in there? Our championship has two centers. Two centers. There's a reason. And we never have a center. For gosh sake, put one in there.
And then the last one we had was Connor Vanover.
Yeah. YouTube, Fishing with Big Sarge, you got to subscribe or I'm not coming on the show anymore. Bonner Bam. Sorry. Listen, thank you for listening. Next Sunday, we're going to have a hoot of a time. So what's tomorrow?
The eclipse.
Y'all be careful out there. This is Big Sarge and the crew. We are
out.